So I want to talk about characteristic map. So this characteristic map will be extremely important to categorize subcomplexes. But the function of characteristic map is even more important than just the characterization of subcomplexes. So we have a space X. Yeah, so this space X is built up of large number of cells. So there could be like the space could contain 20 cells, 2 cells, 3 5 cells, and so on. But we want to fill this space as a solid, yeah, solid both literally and figuratively. So we should be able to fill this space as a solid space, and that is where this attachment map comes into picture. So with each cell which is contained in this space, yeah, suppose there are 20 cells. So E1, 0 and E2, 0, and the space also consists of say 2 cells. Yeah, so we are keeping the index consistent so that we can have a count. So we have E1, E2, E3, E4 and so on. So how do we make the space solid? So the idea is to each cell we associate a disk of the same dimension. So to 0 cell we associate a zero disk, that is a point to a point, so trivial. For to a 2 cell we identify a disk, then similarly for 3 cell a 3 dimensional disk, and like a solid ball, and so on. So that is the precise idea. So you basically take a disk and you attach it to each n cell. So obviously if there are 4 cells we will have 4 characteristic maps, yeah. So for each cell we will have a disk. And this association is as tight as it can be. So as tight as it can be means there is a homeomorphism from interior of the disk onto the interior of the cell. So let me write this down. So you associate disk to each cell. Yeah, so for 0 cell you associate a disk. E0 you associated again a disk, that is just a 0.0 cell. For 2 cells you associate a proper 2 dimensional disk like a saucer. For a 3 cell like solid ball, and so on. And this relationship is as precise as possible. So something which was made up of CW complexes, you have associated solid disks to it so that you can have like a physical feel to the space. So homeomorphism from interior of the disk onto the interior of the cell. Now, while building CW complexes, we had an important map called the attachment map. And we saw that attachment map is always the boundary of the disk. So that has to come into picture here also. So this map, this characteristic map, basically extends the attachment map. So if you restrict this characteristic map to the disk boundary, so interior of the disk it is just a homeomorphism, but when you restrict it to the boundary it becomes an attachment map. And we have to give a good characterization of this, so we have to define it mathematically. We have already seen what attachment map is, so let us just define in a natural way so that we don't have to worry about restrictions. So you take the disk, you embed it into this natural space which came during the inductive construction of CW complexes. Then you project it to Xn, and this Xn embeds itself into X, yeah, because X itself is built up of cells, so whatever n cell you are at you embed it, and there is a projection map here which is basically the attachment map, yeah. So you identify the boundary of the disk with the Xn minus 1 skeleton, and that is pretty much it. That will give us the required construction. Now let us make this clear with the example of a sphere. So again, you know, sphere, you take a two disk, collapse the boundary to a point, and what you get is a sphere. So this is the two disk. Let me draw the boundary in a different color, say red. Now I collapse the boundary to a single point, and what I get at the interior comes out as a sphere. Yeah, so let me shade this a bit, yeah, so that you know what part is getting mapped where. So what do we have? We have a homeomorphism from interior of two cell to interior of disk, and to, if you restrict to the boundary, it's no longer a homeomorphism but an attachment map, and that is pretty much it. Now this characteristic map we will use in a minute or in the next slide to define subcomplexes, but it has much more important properties than that. So later on, what we are going to do is to a space X, we are going to replace this disk with something like delta complexes. Yeah, so instead of disk you are using a triangle, instead of solid ball you are using a tetrahedron. So this will be we'll talk about it later. So but the idea is this. So characteristic map will be something like sigma alpha, and this map is basically on for space X. So you will have these delta complexes, and you will have maps from delta n to x. So there is a description given on page 103 of Hatcher, and you can read that. But the most important criteria to remember is that this is nothing but a characteristic map, and that's it.